G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week we're going to do this face slice effect, adding some fruit slices as we go. This always reminds me of that candy, or as we say here in Australia, those lollies called fruit tingles. I don't know if you guys can remember those. So as usual, let's get started. This is the photo that we're going to use today. All the photos and the links will be in the description below. So the first thing we're going to do is make a selection of our model here, and we're going to use our selection brush tool for that. Just going to make my brush a little bit bigger with my right and left bracket keys just to make it a little bit bigger and just get that selection of our model here. It's a fairly quick selection, just all the way around. And let's get that selected. As we get further down here, I will make my brush a little bit smaller and just get into those areas right down and around. And don't forget her ears here, making our brush a little bit smaller again, just to finish off that fine selection end there. Once we're happy with our selection, we can come up the top here and hit refine. And I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger again using my bracket keys and just go over these areas here and on the other side here. Once we've got our selection and we're happy, we can come over here to selection output and we're going to click on new layer. Hit apply and it's going to put our model on a new layer with a transparent background. The next little bit we're going to do is we're going to add some guidelines. So give me a comment below if you knew that Affinity Photo had guidelines, and we're going to use our rulers. So if you can't see your rulers up here, you can just come to view and down to where it says show rulers and just click that on. So the first thing we're going to do is come up here to our move tool and grab our first guideline. I'm going to drag our first guideline down just above the eyes here, and then we're going to come back up and grab another guideline, and we're going to come down just below the nose, up again to another guideline and drag it down, and we're going to drag that down just below the chin there. So we've got our guidelines here of where we're going to slice up the model's face here. Doesn't sound very good, slice up the model's face, does it? But let's come over here to our rectangular marquee tool. Make sure that we have snapping turned on up here. And the first thing we're going to do is just outside of the box here, let's just draw our selection and snap it to that guideline. So we've got this section of the head selected. Up here to refine and bring up our refine box. And you can see along that line there where it's a little bit rough and it's not going to make the best selection. So on this border width here, I'm going to turn the border width down all the way to zero. And you can see that now gives me a sharper selection. So let's come down here to output again and select new layer and apply. So if you have a look up here now, and on the picture here, we've just got the top of the head. That's good. So let's come back now here to our model layer and click that back on. We've still got our rectangular marquee tool selected, and we're going to select the next section. So we're going to come here to this guideline here and drag our selection down and snap it to our guidelines. We're going to do the same again. Up to refine on our selection box here, turn the border down so we get a nice sharp selection, and then new layer down here on our output box and apply. And then you'll see we've got just the eyes here as well. Back on our layer here again, click it back on, and now we're going to do the same and get a selection of this mouth and nose area. Again, up to the refine box on our selection, refine selection box, turn the borders down. Again, down to our output and new layer and apply. Okay, we've got one more to do. Back on our model layer here, click it back on again. And the last one down here, let's make our selection. Back up to refine. Again, let's turn down that border. Again, output and new layer and apply. And now you can see we've got all 1, 2, 3, 4 slices. We can now get rid of our guidelines. So let's click on our move tool here. Let's just drag our guidelines off the page. We don't need the guidelines anymore. So let's drag them off the page. all the way up. So we've got rid of our guidelines. Don't need this layer switched on anymore, so leave that switched off and leave the background layer switched off as well. And we've just got our slices here. But on the top slice here, what we're going to do is come down here to this little folder, which is the group layers, and click on that for the top. And it's going to put that top slice in a group. And let's call that top of head. Okay, let's do the same for the eyes here, down here to the little folder which adds it into a group, and let's call that group eyes. Same for the mouth here, down to the little folder, let's call that group mouth. And the last one, let's call this chin in its own folder, and let's call that chin. So now we've got all of our slices in their own group. And you'll see why as we go along. Let's take our first slice, the top of the head here. And because we've got a group, we can click on the group and let's just move that out of the way for a minute. Let's just put that up the top here out of the way and take our group here of the eyes and open the eyes group up. And we can just move that a little bit here out of the way as well. But we're going to grab our first piece of fruit, which is going to be a lemon. And I've got the lemon picture here. And I've already made a selection using my selection brush tool all the way around the lemon. It's a fairly easy selection. So all I have to do now is Command C, back to the picture of our model, and Command V. We want to make sure that that lemon slice is in our group for our eyes. So I'm going to drop it into our group. So if you have a look now, it's in the eyes group. If I click on the eyes, the lemon's going to move as well. So let's open that up and just click on the lemon, making sure that we're on our move tool. Let's move that up and make that lemon a little bit smaller. Let's move it up into place here. And we're going to add it onto the top of the eyes here. So we're going to use our perspective tool, and that's down here on our toolbar, perspective tool. So let's click on that. Now it puts this other little box around the lemon so we can actually get this lemon into perspective. So let's click bottom one here and drag it up to the border here of this eye layer. Let's do the same to this side of the lemon, and then let's start manipulating the lemon into place. Just using these little borders here, bring it down a little bit. We wanted to snap it sort of right along the side of her face here. Try and get that a little bit more centered. Once you're happy with what you've got here, let's come down here to apply and click apply, and let's have a look. Not looking too bad. We could probably move it off her eyebrow a little bit more. So let's click back on the lemon layer, back to our perspective tool. I might just lift that up a bit and drop it down a little bit. So we're just off her eyebrow there, maybe a little bit more down here, and a little bit more down here. Let's have a look at that. I'm happy with that. And as we put the lemon in the group of the eyes, if we have a look now and just click on that group, we can now move both. So let's move that one out of the way for a minute, and let's click back on the top of the head. Bring that in. And on this one, I'm going to rotate the head a little bit and just put it here. We've already got our lemon selected over here, so we could just go Command V, but if you're not sure, come back to the lemon and hit Command C and Command V again. And this time we want to make sure this slice of lemon is in the top of the head group. So again, if we move that head, the lemon will move. We open up the group and just click on the lemon. We can make sure we're on our move tool and just bring that down to size. And we're going to add this piece of lemon to the top of the head here. So again, onto our perspective tool, trying to get it in the center and right to the end of these borders of our head here. Just a matter of playing around with it. Have a play. That looks pretty good. Let's hit apply on that and have a look. Yep, I'm happy with that. So let's now click on the group of the top of the head and move that out of the way. We'll come back to that a little bit later. Now we're on to the mouth group. So let's open up the mouth group. Let's just move it so we can work on it a little bit better. Okay, we'll grab our next piece of fruit now, which is going to be our orange. And I've already made a selection on our orange using my selection brush tool here. So let's just go Command C, back to our picture of our model, and Command V. Let's bring our orange up a little bit, making sure that it's in the mouth group. So it's part of that group here. Let's make sure we're clicked on our orange. We'll make it a little bit smaller and bring it up, and we're going to add it to the top of our mouth and nose here. So back over here to our perspective tool, and we're going to drag our anchor points around to get this into place. and right across, all the way across, maybe up a little bit, all the way across here. That's not looking too bad. Let's click on apply. There we've got our orange in place now as well. So click down on that. So that's our mouth group done. Let's just move that. We clicked on our mouth group. Let's move that out of the way and let's work on our chin group now. So let's open up that chin group and click on the picture of the chin. Come over here to our last piece of fruit, which is a piece of kiwi fruit. But as you can see, I've already got a selection. So let's Command C back to our model and Command V. If it's not in the chin group, let's bring it down. It's already gone into the chin group, so we're good. If it wasn't in the chin group, we could just drag it down into the chin group, so it's in that group. Okay, make sure we're clicked on the kiwi fruit. We're on our move tool up the top here, and we'll make that a little bit smaller and bring it into place here on the chin. So we've got it here. Let's grab our perspective tool, and let's start getting that into place as well. So let's manipulate it into place here, down a little bit, down a little bit, and that has clicked in quite well. So let's hit apply, and we've got our kiwi fruit in place here in our group. So now you can see we've got all these groups, and each of these groups has got the fruit and the slice of the face. So let's click on the top of the head group, and let's move that into place where we want it. Click on the eye group, and we'll move that into place, and just move these around the top of the head here. The eyes, I think I'm going to have about here. The mouth, I'm going to bring down and move that to the side. And the chin, I'm going to just bring down a little bit like that as well. You can move these wherever you like. Move that down a little bit. Move that in. That's not looking too bad. Like I said, you can move it wherever you like. So the next thing we're going to do is add a little bit of shadow. So I'm going to come to the top of the head group here. I'm going to open it up, and I'm going to add a new pixel layer down here on new pixel layer, add pixel layer. I'm going to make sure it's in the top of that head group. I'm going to make sure I'm painting in black. I'm going to make sure I've got a nice soft brush. Make sure that stays on black. Come over here and get our paint brush. Let's make sure the opacity and the flow are 100%. The hardness can stay at zero. Make sure that this doesn't flip back to white. If it does, we can hit X on our keyboard to swap them, or just swap them here on this arrow. So we've got this black dot here. Let's make it a little bit smaller. And just right in the middle here, let's just click a black dot. So we've got this black dot layer. Let's come over here to our move tool, and let's just stretch that out all the way along. Nice and stretched. Maneuver that in place, and let's turn down that opacity. Maybe move that up a little bit. And we're just maneuvering that for a little bit of shadow. Maybe down a little bit more on the opacity to about 50%. And let's just move that into place. So that's good. So let's click on that shadow layer and go Command J. And let's grab that one and move that into the eyes group. So I'm just grabbing it, moving it under the eyes group, and moving it to the right. So that'll put that in the eyes group. Let's do that again. Command J, bring that down and put it in the mouth group. So just bring it down right underneath the mouth group and moving it to the right. Dropping that in there, so let's just click that. And then let's do the same for the chin group. Command J, and let's move that all the way down to the chin group to the right. So we've got a shadow layer in every group. Let's come to the eyes and the shadow group in the eyes, and let's move that one down here to the orange. A little bit of shadow over there. Let's also come here to the mouth on the shadow group. Let's move that one down here to the kiwi fruit, and we can always move it and make it a bit bigger and manipulate it. Let's put that one in. We need to make that a bit smaller, and we've got our shadow on our kiwi fruit. And one more thing I'm going to do on that shadow for the kiwi fruit, I'm going to Command J again and add another copy. I'm going to bring that down and move it around, make it a lot smaller, and I'm going to add a little bit of shadow down the side here, and I'm going to make that a little bit lighter again and just add that shadow there. So that's in the chin. Let's open up our mouth group now and add another Command J, copy that shadow again. And this one, I'm going to move up, make it a bit smaller, and I'm going to add it down the side here and just stretch that out a little bit. Again, I'll drop the opacity on that a little bit more and move that up into place there. Just have a play, turn that round. But there we go. We've got all our layers in place with our fruit on our slices of our face. So the last thing I'm going to do on this picture, going to make sure my black is selected again. So I'll hit X on my keyboard to make sure that's black. Going to come over here to my rectangular tool. Make sure I've got the rectangle tool selected, the square, and I'm going to draw a square over the top of all those slices, and then I'm going to move that all the way down to the bottom so we've got all our slices on a black background. If we want to, we can do some cleanup around the sides. If you wanted to, you could also add a splash background or some water splashes or some drops if you wanted as well. So there we go, everybody. That is the face slice, what I call the fruit tingle in Affinity Photo. So if you have enjoyed the tutorial this week, please don't forget to subscribe. Hit that bell so you get notified when I do new videos. So until next time, guys, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.